Today we will learn superpositions theorem. It is very important theorem to solve the electrical circuit. So first of all, we have to understand what is superpositions theorem. Superpositions theorem states that current flowing through a branch is equal to the algebraic sum of current taking one source at a time while other source replaced by open circuit or short circuit. That means if we have a voltage source, then it will be replaced by open circuit and current source replaced by short circuit. That means the limitation of superposition is that circuit should be linear and bilateral and circuit must have at least two energy sources. That means energy source may be a voltage source or may be current source or both voltage source or both current source. That means we must have two and more than two energy sources. In this circuit, I have taken one voltage source and one current source, and our objective is to find the current in 6 ohm resistor. So, what is the step to solve the superpositions theorems? We have to take one source. So, case first, take 18 volt and draw the circuit diagram by taking only one source and this current source will be replaced by open circuit. Let I1 current will flow in 6 ohm. So, applying any theorems, any law, we can find easily the value of current in 6 ohm. Here the value of I1 is equal to 18 divided by 12 plus 6 is equal to 18 by 18, that is 1 ampere, and the direction is downward. There is no current in 8 ohm resistor because it is open circuit. Second case, take 3 ampere. When we will take 3 ampere, that is the current source, the other source will be short circuited because it is the voltage source. So, 18 volt replaced by short circuit. That means when we take 3 ampere current, then what is the value of current? Let I2 current flowing in 6 ohm. So, we have to find the value of 6 ohm. Value of I2 in 6 ohm resistor. So, there is so many methods you can apply here, mesh analysis, nodal analysis or current division rule. Simple, we have 3 ampere current and 3 ampere current reached at this node and current will divide in 12 and 6. So, the value of current I2 may be given as 3 into second resistor 12 divided by 12 plus 6, that is 3 into 12 divided by 18, that is 2 ampere current in downward direction. So, we have two results, this is I1 and this is I2. According to superpositions theorems, we have to find the current in 6 ohm and we have to find the value of I and it will be equal to the sum of algebraic sum of I1 and I2. So, the value of I is I1 plus I2. So, I1 here 1 ampere and I2 is 2 ampere. The direction is downward direction. So, the total current in 6 ohm is 3 ampere. This is the resultant current. Similarly, you may ask what is the value of current in 12 ohm. So, in 12 ohm resistor, the value of current is same because in series, when we case, when we taken case first, the current will be same. Current in 12 ohm is same as I1. That is, here current in 12 ohm resistor is also 1 ampere and the direction is forward direction. And when we take second case, then the current in 12 ohm resistor, it is I3 suppose. So, using current division rule again, we can find here I3 is given by 3 into second resistor is here 6 divided by 6 plus 12, that is 3 into 6 by 18, that is 1 ampere and the direction is backward. So, the resultant current is what? Resultant current 1 ampere forward direction and 1 ampere backward direction. So, the total current 1 ampere in downward direction and the resultant is 1 minus 1 is equal to 0 ampere. That means current in 12 ohm is 0 ampere, which is desired answer, and the current in 6 ohm is 3 ampere. Okay.